students. So today we had a very successful online class with you, and I am so happy the way I interacted with you. You all are very active, and that made me very enthusiastic and very energetic. Thank you so much for joining me today in the class. I am scheduling the next class by tomorrow or day after. So today we are starting. As per our discussion, unanimously you all wanted me to start the economics chapter. So children, here I come with your economics. Now I know why you all were so enthusiastic, why you all were so much keen about studying economics, because it's a new subject. Till class 8, the subjects that you have studied were history, civics and geography. But this year we are introducing the new book, that is economics. So you have total, children, you have total four chapters here. First is the story of village Palampur. Chapter 2 is people as resource, and chapter 3 is poverty as a challenge, and chapter 4 is food security in India. Now students, please try to understand, why do we study economics? In the meantime, while the time I am explaining, I am just going to the chapter. I have already opened the book. So students, we are starting with this chapter. Now let me make one thing very clear. We study economics so that we can understand that what money is all about. How do we function, and what are the economic ways of working, and how do we spend and keep a check on our economic transactions that we do. What are we buying? What are we keeping? What is an asset? What is a liability? So many things, so many points that are related to economic transactions, we will be studying in this book, all about that. But to make your chapter, to make economics something very easy for you, children, here we have a very nice story of this village Palampur. Now you might be wondering, now where is village Palampur? I'll tell you, just see, very clearly it is mentioned here. I hope it's clear to you. Now I'm using a new app today to record my chapter, and I know it will really help you all, because I feel this is more clear and the sound is also very clear, so it will really help you to understand the chapter properly. Okay, so these children, I'm highlighting it. It is a hypothetical village. Hypothetical, we have just, it's imaginary, you know. I mean, we have taken, of course, we have taken a live example of villages that are found in India, but we have just named it as Palampur. Okay, now a question that is very frequently asked is, what were the activities the people in Palampur were involved in? What all work they were doing? Okay, so very clearly mentioned here, the work that the people in Palampur were doing, farming. Most of them were farmers. Okay, so the activity, the work that they were involved in was farming. And other activities were also there. What were those activities? Manufacturing, dairy, transport, etc. Other than farming also, there has to be activities, na, where people have to really put in their efforts to see that the village is functioning properly. Because what happens is, only farming, people cannot survive only on farming. These production activities need various types of resources, like natural resources, man-made resources, human effort, money, you know. Farming is happening, so for the farming you need tools, then you need people who are working,
they need transport to take the food from, to take the crops from one place to the other place. Then how all these people have combined the resources? Various resources are there to sustain the people who were living in Palampur, and they produce the desired goods and services in the village. You know, in village, the people who are there a little bit educated, they open their offices, they help the people in getting loan. Now what happens is that there are economic activities that is going on in the villages very properly, and banks are also there. So there are government organizations which are giving funds to the farmers. Apart from that, there are non-government organizations also which are helping them. Now please try to understand questions that are very frequently asked from this chapter, children. So you need to understand, please check it. Now a very frequently asked question for 1 mark. Palampur is connected to which villages nearby? Raiganj is a big village, and which is 3 kilometers from Palampur, and other village is Shahpur. Children, please remember the name of these two villages. One is village and other one is town. So Raiganj and Shahpur. Many type of transports are available to connect these villages and towns. Bullock carts, tongas, you know na, ghoda gadi, yeah, bogies, wooden. Now what are bogies? Meaning is given here, children. Just see what are bogies. Bogies are wooden cart drawn by buffaloes, loaded with jaggery. Now what is jaggery? Just see in the bracket, the explanation is given here. Good. Other commodities are taken to these two motorcycles, like motor vehicles are also used, because we are using the ancient mode of communication. In the same way, we are using the modern ways of communication as well. So motorcycles, jeeps, tractors and trucks. Now children, another very frequently asked question is, how many families are there in this village? 450 families are there. They belong to several castes and houses. Some of them are large, some of them are cement plasters. There are SCs, there are STs, all kind of people are living there. But as it is a village area, so what we find is that, children, SCs and Dalits, which are a large number of population is there, they live in smaller houses, some of which are of course, small houses are there, made of mud and straw. So try to understand. That the people in Palampur are not very well off. I mean, I just wanted to say that economically they are not very sound. Okay, children? Electricity is there, yes. Of course, the village is a bit backward kind of a village. But electric powers are used. Tube wells are there in the field. And a small business people are using. In the small business, Palampur has try to understand. Next question that could be, how many schools are there? There are 2 primary schools and 1 high school. And health center is there, big hospital is not there. Children, try to understand, as it's a small village, so a health center is there, which is run by the government, and 1 private dispensary where the sick are treated. Children, what happens is now that the doctors and the people who get the medical education, they go in the cities, they open their big hospitals there, and they earn a lot of money. But some people are there who belong to the villages, and they take care of the people who are living in the villages. We must really thank them for staying back in the village, not thinking about earning their money and providing their services to the village people. Okay, children? Palampur has, it's a not very backward village, it is a small village, and it has got well developed system of road, transport, electricity, irrigation, school, health center. So all these facilities that are there, it is compared to the nearby village. Now children, just now that we have discussed in the first paragraph, it is an imaginary village. But different types of activities that are going on in the town. Children, try to understand, we are talking about the major activity. Remember, what did we discuss? Farming activities. But other than farming activities, kya kya hai? Abhi everybody is not working in the farms, na? Other people who are working in other places. Non-farming activities are manufacturing, transport, shopkeeping, etc. So we'll take a look at both these types of activities and general things about production. Okay children, now we come to the next topic. So first topic that we have completed, it was an overview of the village Palampur. So you have to go through that properly. And now we come to the next topic, that is the organization of production. Children, this is first you need to understand the introduction part where we have read a lot about the village Palampur and its complete surroundings. Now, the people who are involved, they are involved in what business? Production. You know, I mean, not only activities related to farm, other than farming activities, people who are involved into production, we have to understand for production of goods and services. You know, I mean, farm activities are there, but along with the farm activities, the people who are involved in other activities, they need some support. Now, what kind of a support is there? Just check, children. If you are doing into production, you are manufacturing anything, the first requirement that is needed, factors of production, is land. Okay? And other natural resources that are related to land, water, forest, minerals. So, water resources are one of the most, land resources are one of the most important factors of production. Okay, children? Because we are producing now, so this is the all about the organization of production. First is land. Now this is a, children try to understand, this is a question that is asked for a 5 marks question. So you have to do this question in detail, this topic in detail, that the first requirement for production is land. What is the second? Yes children, it's already mentioned here, labor. Means land is there, but then we don't have people to work on that land. So what will happen? It is useless to have land. So the next important thing after land that is needed for production is labor. And other activities also are there, who can do a manual work, other activities, the people, land is there, labor is there, but laborers who can do manual work, means by hand. You know, machines are not there, na? Big machines are not available in the village areas. So, the people who are engaged into the manual activities. So each worker is providing the labor necessary for production. Now, you have got land, you have got land, and you have got labor. Next important thing that is needed for organization of production. What is that, children? Yes, you can see it is very clearly mentioned here. Physical capital. Now just see what is physical capital. Children, again for 3 marks, it's a very frequently asked question. In physical capital, there are 2 categories. Children, you have to understand this properly. I'm sorry. Uh, what happens is when material is being produced and material are being public for production, land, labor, and then other thing is capital. That is, during production you need various kind of capital. Fixed is there and working capital. Now a very frequently asked question for 3 marks is, what is a working capital and what is a fixed capital? So here it is very clearly mentioned here. The tools, machines, buildings come under the category of fixed capital, and working capital mein you have raw material and money. Fixed means it is found at one place only. Children, fixed hai wo. And working capital, which keeps on changing. Raw material, sometime you need cement, sometime you need gitti, sometime you need sand, balu chahiye. So raw material. And then sometime you need 1,000 rupees, sometimes you need 10,000 rupees. So money in hand. Working keeps on changing. Fixed is machine, we need this machine only for production. So that machine. Okay. So fourth requirement is also there, and land, labor, physical capital, and the last and the most important one, children, human resource. Got it? Just see, it is mentioned here. Human capital. Fixed capital is there, working capital. Remember, children? And now the next one that is very important is the human capital. Just see the picture here. Very nicely it is explained in this picture. So you can go through this picture with several laborers and machines are there. So all these things when we combine, please remember, children, very important, what are the major factors of production? So land, labor, physical capital, human capital, all this when combined together, then it is called as the factor of production. So we will learn about the first 3 factors of production first, and then we will be continuing the other one. Children, we have gone through the introduction and then the factors of production. Okay, what are the production? Lot of things that you need to understand and that you need to identify clearly. So please go through it properly, and then only we'll be going to the next topic, that is the farming in Palampur. Okay, this we will be doing in the next module. Thank you, children.